Hi, and welcome to Theoretically Practical. Last week, an episode just did not happen. I was trying to get that hydraulic radiator fixed for the Dynaho, and I went through a lot of welding processes, and I did find one that works, but I don't have enough of the welding rod. I've ordered more. You'll see that later. This week is sort of a simple one. We've got this Walker zero-turn tractor universal implement mount. It's not a universal implement mount, it's just an implement mount. And this linear actuator on it is deader than a doornail. So my buddy did get the wiring kit for it, finally tried to plug it in, and it doesn't move at all. So I suspect the motor's bad, but you know, we'll see if there's anything else wrong in there, and we'll tear it down and get it working again, hopefully. So first thing I did is just hook up a plus and a minus. Since it's not at the end of stroke and it goes forwards and backwards, polarity shouldn't matter. So I took that, hooked up the things, and connected it to a battery, and while it sparks and these very thin wires get very hot, nothing at all happens on this. So we're gonna open it up because I think we need to. I've never taken one of these apart before, but it seems like the motor's the bad part, and I've fixed a lot of little DC motors. Wow, I'm gonna bring you guys over to see this lovely. There's just a touch of moisture in there. So remember how I was all like, yeah, I'm gonna fix this thing, no big deal. 99% chance it's junk at this point. But we'll soldier on. I've revived things that looked worse, not necessarily forever, but for a time. All right. Let's see if we can, oh yeah. Well, it does turn on that. Actually, pretty feels okay. What does that do? That's just the thrust bearing. But if the whole thing is just full of water, yeah, this, I don't know if you guys could see, but there's definitely some good cracks in this seal. But then again, this tube was sealed to the outside of this, so other than this being pretty scuzzed up, we might be okay. It's gonna have a limited lifespan just because these balls are, it's a recirculating ball screw, and they work great, but they don't really handle being packed full of garbage forever. Go. Okay, so, I mean, it's a little bit of rust in here. Yeah, I did not need to remove that bolt, but this isn't full of water. Gears all look all right. And I can see why I couldn't pull it out, because there's just a little key right there. Put that on top of that. Well, this motor is also absolutely seized up. So, pull that apart too. I don't know, this might actually work out all right. I mean, again, some of this is probably junk now, but not all of it. Where the hell is the hammer I had 5 freaking minutes ago? Jeez. Well, this is the hammer, apparently, because I can find it. Apparently, it was the right tool for the job. All right. I'm going to stick these back on here one more time. Give them a tap now that I've actually possibly freed everything, but it's just going to be a gentle tap. Yeah, that's all I needed. I'm sure the brushes in this aren't gonna fly off and go everywhere and absolutely piss me off till the end of time. can't possibly happen. There we go. Uh-oh. Yeah, there's water coming out of this too. Man, I would have thought these things would have been a little bit waterproof. Well, there's your problem, lady. So, no wonder this didn't spin. It's just absolutely rusted and crusted up. And then the commutator's pretty bad too. So, but I don't want to push it out because it's staked in. So I'm just going to hose it down with whatever I have as far as, you know, lubricant goes. And hopefully a little bit of it gets in where it needs to. What do I got? So I did get this off the shaft, but I had to, I tried to hammer it out, and of course it popped right out of that little spring cage, which is captivated. I can't get take it out to put it back in, but I can probably force that back in there and rotate it around. I will have to sand down the couple of tool marks I put in it. But this is supposed to be the bearing surface, and it's just way too tight because this is all just cooked on with old garbage. So we're going to take this over the lathe, and I'm just going to hit this with some Scotch-Brite just to take off the high spots. And that actually looks like it's cracked, which is strange. And then I'm going to hit the commutator. Just again, I'm just going to hit it with some Scotch-Brite. That'll clean it right up. And then I'm going to hit this with some Scotch-Brite. So yeah, I'll just be right back. It's going to take me 30 seconds. All right, so that's pretty much cleaned up. Again, you're not trying to get this to be shiny again. It doesn't matter. You just want the highs off of it so they don't hit the sides on this unit. I also just hosed it off with some brake clean because it's just full of water, and the brake clean will actually pull the water out of it too. So I just give a little squirt. There we go. That's just a little hard. See, so now you see how it spins there. That is how a bearing should work. We're still gonna put a little bit of that grease in there. We put it back together again, but that, yeah, a little white lithium grease. Oh yeah, it's just a little tight right at the top, but that's okay. All right, so I got a little of this white lithium grease. I like it because you can just spray it in. You can be pretty sparing with it though. So just a little dab will do ya. And hopefully this will just find its way back through the hole from whence it came. I don't have a lot of hope of that, but. All right, I just went around right at the points and popped them up with a screwdriver. So actually, I think this might have been a good maneuver because then I can pull this out. I should replace this, but I don't have anything to replace it with. We're just gonna scrape the inside of that out a little bit. Okay. There we go. Now this, we're gonna just hose down with the white lithium grease. There we go. Put that back in the hole. Put this guy back in the hole. Put the keeper. I'm just wiping the lithium grease off my hands onto it. Back in the hole. And then this guy should go back in the hole. That'll do it. And then just go with like a screwdriver or what have you and just punch a little bit over. I mean, that's how they did it originally. Which is really difficult to do on top of a desk. All right, so that's restaked back in a couple places. I know this thing doesn't look beautiful, but I don't think it has to win any beauty contests. In any case, the bearing is held in its cage and that doesn't go on to pop out, so I'll call that a success. So now we got this end, and this end just needs a quick blast of some brake cleaner, maybe a little brushing, and then we'll just put a little bit of lithium grease down the middle like we did on the other end, and that's about it. So this is super cool. I'm about 99% sure that this is the limit switch. And how it works is it's just like a set of points in an engine, but as it gets hot, it's going to open up and disconnect the circuit. So when it gets to the end of travel, it's going to stall the motor. The motor's going to heat up and it's going to open, and that's going to be all you need. And, you know, I think that's a pretty good idea, to be fair. I wish I had a points cleaner, but I don't want to bend that open too much. And I know I had some continuity through there, so. Okay, so now I've just put the little bolts on. You've got this greasy motor, but it does rotate by hand because it's not completely rusted to hell. So we're gonna hook it up to this battery over here. We'll see what she does. Okay, contact. There we go. Okay, and does it go the other way when I reverse them? I'm sure it does, but... yep, so perfect. So now we have a working motor. Now let's deal with the bad stuff. I'm gonna start by just cleaning up whatever will come off of that. Oh wow, that is grody. I wonder if that all comes apart. No. Oh, there's supposed to be thrust bearings in that. All right, after screwing with a little bit more, this just pushes on to the top of that, so you can just slide that off. And then there's a pin here that you would need to push out, but I don't have this bearing here, and I tried to wallop this pin a little bit, and it is stuck. So I'm just going to spray all this out with brake clean as best I can, and get it as clean as I can. I mean, nothing. It just feels like it sat and lost it. So I just clean up this as much as I can. When I think I've hit that point, I'll just hose everything down with white lithium grease. Hopefully, I will have most of the water out of this part. And then we'll put it back together again, because it'll work, you know, and it'll probably work for quite a while like that, so. All right, so this is pretty well back together and pretty well lubed up. It definitely moves easy, but I can tell that the balls in it are, it shouldn't be that rattly, but it is what it is. Then you got this little sort of a thrust washer, I think, and then you've got this bad boy. All right, guys, so it's rebuilt, it's relatively clean. The end here is only held from rotating by what it's mounted to, I guess. So, and if you're going to do this, put the jumpers on this side first and then tap the connection on the battery just so you don't burn up your terminals. Oh wow, oh, that probably pulls more amps than these stupid little things can stand. All right, it does kind of work with these. They're just gonna almost melt in my hands. There you go. And then we'll reverse. I think that wire completely, oh yeah, the wire completely just burned out. They put one freaking hair in these. They're nice, but I wish, well, they're nice to have, but I wish they were more useful. But anyways, that's a good bench test. It works. I'm gonna bring it back to my buddy's house and we'll get some video of it in action. And yeah. Running down a few times though. I wasn't able to run the motor all that much with it like that. I wonder if it's just a little, well, there we go. It's coming back around. Here, you want to pull the
the pin out of the top if there's no tension on it. And man, those are stout. It really needs that ground. Oh,
that's funny.
Ooh. Yeah, just spin it for a little bit. Now go the other way for a little while. All right, stop sitting. I just want to make sure it'll... Wow, it's... it's not that happy. Either that or you're all the way at the end of travel. Oh, there we go. Or is it you just slowing it down?
That's weird.
Yeah. I think those balls are are toast. Well, try to line it up with that. We'll stick it back on again. I don't think it's the motor. I think it's the actuator, unfortunately. This is something you're going to see in a little bit for another project. It is the same brand and basically the same actuator, just a much longer throw.
And brand new.
And brand in it. Yeah, that one hasn't been full of water.
Yet.
Yet. You've lost your ground again. It doesn't take any effort to keep that from spinning. So I think, unfortunately, those ball screws are tough. Oop.
That's what end of travel looks like, then. Huh? You're probably not going to be able to hold
no,
on to
I'm
that.
Not even going to try. It'll just take my fingers off. I think that sounds like ball screw to me.
Sounds good.
Well, at least we're 50%.
I like it. This one obviously works.
Yeah.
That's going to be nice and quiet.
Mm-hmm.
Sweet.
Yeah.
All right, so we're kind of thinking that maybe it's not meant for that particular attachment. It's really more for the snowblower tools that need it. So I'm going to stand on it, and we're going to see if it'll make me go up and down. Whoa. Yeah, no, not too... I mean, it's definitely struggling, but...
He's struggling in both directions.
That's, you know...
It's not just weight. It's
no.
It's resistance. It's friction.
I think those balls and that ball screw are shot. Possibly the balls themselves could fix the problem, but, hey, it does move again, and that was the point. Goes to show, though, without parts, there's only so much you can do. We ain't Pakistani truck out here, so... All right, guys, that'll be it for this week. You guys have a great week, and I got a new project that if you follow me on Instagram, and I'll put the Instagram here because I don't remember my own Instagram, yeah, you'll be able to see it. So have a great week.